there, fellow scientists. I am so glad you decided to join me for some blacklight bowling. Ooh, a strike! Oh, yeah. Bowling is fun, but these blacklights really bring it to the next level. What are you waiting for? Go get a ball before... who turned on the lights? You know, I was having so much fun, I didn't even stop to wonder. Why do those lights make my snazzy outfit glow like that anyway? Well, by the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to describe non-visible light and explain some of its uses and dangers. Let's get into it. Remember, human eyes are capable of perceiving only certain wavelengths of light, which represent a tiny fraction of the entire electromagnetic spectrum. The wavelengths of light that humans cannot see are called non-visible light. Even though our eyes can't see non-visible light, scientists have learned a lot about it, including ways it can be both helpful and harmful. Non-visible light can have wavelengths that are much shorter than the visible spectrum. Do you remember what color has the shortest wavelength? Violet light has the shortest wavelength of the visible spectrum. When the wavelengths are even shorter than violet, we get ultraviolet or UV light. The wavelength of ultraviolet light ranges from 400 to only 10 nanometers. For context, 10 million nanometers make up 1 centimeter. So we're talking really small here. If you've ever gone blacklight bowling like me, or maybe even used a blacklight to find clues in an escape room, you've experienced an interesting effect of UV light. These wavelengths of light interact with some substances in a special way, causing them to fluoresce or glow. While the amount of UV light in a black light is safe, ultraviolet light isn't all fun and games. A portion of the light we receive from the sun is ultraviolet light. Overexposure to this UV light is what causes sunburns. Ouch! Continued exposure to UV light can lead to more serious long-term health problems, including skin cancer. Most UV light from the sun is blocked from reaching the Earth by our atmosphere, but some still reaches us. That's why it's important to wear plenty of sunscreen when you're spending long periods of time in the sun. Sunscreen works by blocking the wavelengths of UV light, causing them to reflect rather than absorb into your skin. While UV light can be harmful, it can also be very helpful too. Our bodies require some UV light to produce vitamin D. Vitamin D helps our bodies to absorb nutrients like calcium, that stuff that keeps our bones strong and healthy. That's why it's good to get out and spend some time in the sunshine when we can. What experiences have you had with UV light? Good or bad, pause the video here and describe your experience in your guided notes. Light waves can get even shorter than ultraviolet light. When light has a wavelength between 10 nanometers and just 1/100th of a nanometer, we have X-rays. X-rays are so small they can pass through materials that other light can't, which is how doctors are able to use X-rays to create images of your bones. The shortest wavelengths of light give us gamma rays. These wavelengths can be even smaller than the width of an atom. These types of light are produced by some of the hottest, highest energy objects in the universe, such as the explosion of supernovas. Gamma rays are not often found on Earth, though a very small percentage of lightning strikes can contain gamma rays. There are also wavelengths of light that are longer than the visible spectrum. Do you remember what color of the visible spectrum has the longest wavelength? Red has the longest wavelength of visible light. When the wavelength of light is longer than red, we get infrared light. Infrared wavelengths range from 700 nanometers to 1 millimeter, which is about the width of the tip of a sharpened pencil. While infrared light is invisible to the human eye, we can still sense it in another way: heat. In fact, infrared light was first discovered in 1800 when a scientist named William Herschel was measuring for differences in the temperature of light in the visible spectrum. He observed an increased temperature reading from violet to red, but he was surprised to find the highest temperature was beyond the red end of the spectrum, where there didn't appear to be light at all. He had discovered infrared light. We incorporate infrared light into our technology in many different ways. For example, thermal cameras allow us to see with very little visible light. Instead of relying on visible light, these cameras sense heat being emitted by any people, animals, or objects around. We also use infrared light in lasers, heat lamps, and even some remote controls. Infrared light is what sends signals between the remote and the television. Even longer wavelengths of light are called microwaves. Microwaves range from 1 millimeter to 30 centimeters, or about a foot long. Microwaves are used for communication, navigation, astronomy, and yes, heating food in your kitchen. Even longer than microwaves are radio waves, which can extend from 30 centimeters to 100 kilometers, or more than 60 miles long. The long length of these waves allows us to send information over extremely long distances, making them very useful for things like radio, television, and satellite communication. Non-visible light makes up much more of the electromagnetic spectrum than visible light does. Pause the video here and complete the diagram of the whole light spectrum in your guided notes now. Let's review everything we've learned about non-visible light. Non-visible light includes all the wavelengths the human eye cannot see. Non-visible light with shorter wavelengths than the visible spectrum include ultraviolet light, X-rays, and gamma rays. Non-visible light with longer wavelengths than the visible spectrum include infrared light, microwaves, and radio waves. To learn more about non-visible light, be sure to check out the practice questions and activities that go with this lesson. So my lab coat glows under these lights as a reaction to the ultraviolet light being emitted. Let's see if those UV lights can also give my bowling skills a glow up. Ooh, another steer, right? Is there infrared light in here? Or am I on fire? Until next time, scientists, remember, science is all around us. See ya! Oh, come on, a split! Oh. Stop recording. Stop. Stop recording. Stop it. Hey, hey.